Hello everyone, welcome back to an episode of Dark Souls. Now you'll notice I'm not in the Cathedral of the Deep anymore. It turns out I kinda ended up killing the boss accidentally, which is the Deacons of the Deep. It's actually a very easy boss, so if you guys, you know, whenever you guys would go to play it, if you haven't already, they're very easy to fight. If you have, like, a decent amount of stamina, or whatever it's considered, I guess it'd be endurance for here. If you have just, like, a basic amount of endurance, like I do, I have, like, 14, you'll easily rip right through them. I would actually suggest using, like, a big two-handed weapon. This way you can hit more, because, like, there's a lot of regulars, but then there's also, like, the main ones you want to hit. But I did go to the Farron area, so I want to complete a little bit of this area. I want to go up here and do a boss fight, actually.
Ooh.
Fatty ahead. Call my guy fat. He's Luffy. It's actually the Exiled Armor. It's very high in defense. It's actually better than Morn's armor in a lot of ways. Now this area, there's actually quite a few secrets. I did go through this area on my sorcerer, so you know, there is that. I'm gonna read message. Read message. Read message. There's a message here and I won't see it. Me wants message? Fine. Okay, last time I fought him was with the sorcerer, and I actually did it kind of cheatingly. And I don't know if I have that same kind of luck with this one. I don't think I will, because he already has spotted me. Ah! Oh, jeez. Let me go! I didn't do well. That really didn't go well. But the nice thing with the sorcerer when you go against him is you can use, like, I don't know, like the soul arrow. Matter of fact, what for spells do I have? Yeah, I don't have anything that's really going to help me with this battle, so I'm going to have to do this very intelligently. Obviously, he's quite powerful. Why is that glowing, I wonder? Lift? There we go. Yeah, I kinda died pretty pathetically there, didn't I? Alright, let's try that again. That was insanely pitiful. Is there really nothing here to invading another world? I didn't choose to invade. I don't want to invade. What? I never selected to invade. Why is it making me invade somebody? Okay, so you're going to see my first invasion that I did to somebody. Like, as you guys seen, I never selected to invade somebody. The heck? So, let me get this straight. Did that just screw up my souls that I lost to the boss? Because I never actually selected to go to that world. Okay. That was actually incredibly weird. Okay, my souls are still there, thank God. Bad thing is, they're actually pretty close to the boss. Seriously, what the hell? See, when I fought him with my sorcerer, all he did was he went against the gate, and I just kept blasting him with the heavy soul arrow, and he didn't stand the chance. So, I still don't get that invasion. Like, as you guys seen, I didn't select invade anybody. So why would my guy automatically go to invade somebody without me saying, hey, go invade? This armor does not seem to be helping me much against this boss. I mean, it's not hurting me, it's just it's not helping me either. I mean, unless you have no control of whenever you go to. Well, let me see something here. Maybe it does slow my guy down some. What was I using? I was using this. Let me try something. I don't think it actually really does anything. That's the stuff I was using. Well, maybe I am a little bit faster now. Well, maybe it's all in my head too, I don't know. Okay, so this boss is not going to be easy. Literally one swing of that axe. This is what I did against Worrell the first time I fought him. Except he didn't have a sit on me move. Oh, jeez. It would make sense he could attack with his tail. I just never realized he could attack with his tail. Wow. Yeah, that never dawned on me that he would be able to do that. I mean, it makes a complete logical sense. It's just, wow. I dropped the ball on that one. Oh. I don't have enough bolts to really make it worthwhile. I should probably not do that, just in case for whatever reason my guy actually does get caught on that. So that's kind of interesting, invading somebody else, but I still don't get the. Ooh, that's right, I wanted to change that out. I still don't get it because I actually didn't select to invade anybody. So that's what doesn't make sense to me. You know what? I think I might actually change that out with this one. Lower equip load increases attack. So the weak. Ooh, hey. Praise the rear! Yeah. That's what I was going for, but I failed. That's what he did the last time I. Like, back when I fought him with my sorcerer. Oh, come on, not this again. Oh, jeez. He's killing me in two swipes. See, that's what makes these bosses so freaking hard. Because they can, like, destroy you before you even realize what just happened. Let's try this again. And the funny thing is, like, I've been doing this, and I've been just, like, ripping through everything up to this point. And there's really, you don't miss much to get to this point. But I did want to show you this boss. And the thing of it is, he's not even, like, a main boss, he's a mini-boss. And the one after this, I believe, is the Abyss Watchers. Which, you guys, I don't know... Yeah, I think I recorded that a little bit. But yeah, that boss fight is like uberly insane. Yeah, I wish there was something here to help me. What a jerk. He defeats me, then he throws me off the edge too. It's like, wow, you couldn't just be happy with, you know, crushing me in your hand. No, you had to go the one step above and beyond and just throw me. Yeah, fatty's ahead. Alright. Do I have a better helmet then? New. Yeah, see, I got the Pope hat. Alright. See, it's all about timing with this game. If you have, like, really good timing, you'll do fine. If you have horrible timing, you won't do fine. I don't quite get what those talismans do. Like, I really don't understand these. So I'm gonna go with that one. Why? I don't know. I want to. I kinda wanna go for the sun. For whatever reason, I wanna use the rosary one. Okay, I wanna kinda wait until he has his back turned. What? I didn't even push roll and he just rolls right in front of him. I'm thinking I need to have a two-handed weapon going soon. Otherwise, this kind of stuff is going to happen a lot. I notice a lot of people seem to use two-handed weapons. And that seems to be great for, like, bosses and for PvP action, but for the little guys, it's better to have a shield. Wow, 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 wow. Yeah, because, like, all these little guys, having a shield up, especially for archers, especially metal shield at that, it's just incredibly useful. I do love this game. I love the style of it. I love the degree of difficulty to it. Hey, how about somebody actually... I really wish I could summon something to help me with this battle. Okay, wait until he turns around again. Come on. Turn around, butthole. There we go. Yes. Oh, that was loud. That was really, really loud in the ear holes. See, he wasn't bad once you get used to it. It's just the point of getting used to it. A couple embers. Battle to me really wasn't that worth it, other than the souls I obtained from it. The other side of that gate, I can't get to it quite right now, but eventually, yes. Okay. Right there. Okay, there's got to be a way to get to that sign. Oh wait, that's right, I don't want to go this way. Yeah, see, there's platforms over there. That's what I love about this game, there's actually a lot of secrets to it too. So you really want to keep an eye out for any secret you can find. Curious. Time for hidden path. It's not really too hidden. It's just, you gotta be observant. Okay, I just gotta drop down to this one. Run to this one? Nope, just drop down. Okay. Yeah, so you couldn't quite get to this side just by you know. Yeah. One. There's the other. Whew. You see, if that dragon was alive, I'd... Lightning spear. Something tells me that spell is actually very rare. Dragon crest shield. I wonder how good that is compared to my shield. I have a regular crest. Okay, so the defense... Ooh. Defense against fire is really up there, but dark is really down, so... Yeah, that actually reminds me. I was kind of curious, so I was looking around for Egwin, or whatever his name is. And, because I thought, well, I got his ring, maybe I can, you know... Shut up. Oh, come on, you little jerk. Okay, that got me a heavy gem. But yeah, I was looking around for him, and I couldn't find him at his usual spot, which is, you know, right where you find the priestess. So I thought, you know, okay, well, maybe he's only there here and there. So, ooh, you have fire arrows. You're a bit of a jerk. Yeah, so I thought, well, maybe he's just not there all the time. And... So I was kind of exploring back at the shrine, because I wanted to see if there's anything I was missing. And it turned out I seen him in the distance. He was near, like, the first boss. Like, basically your introductory boss into the game. Which... Even though it was still an introductory boss to the game, it was quite epic and hard, if you ask me. And, well, when I walked up to him, vision of misfortune. Okay. He actually just automatically attacked me, saying as long as you remember our deal, as long as you, she was alive and protected, you, we would be allies. And then he just went up and attacked me, and I wasn't expecting it, so obviously he killed me right off the bat. Whoa! That hurt. Yeah, so obviously, you know, he killed me right away. But if anybody knows, like, why he ended up attacking, please let me know, because I left her alone, and the next thing I know, well, I also did, I checked back into the keep itself, and she wasn't there anymore. It's like, well, I never killed her. I guess maybe there's so many tomes, and once she gets all the tomes, like, she just dies. Which would be kind of a crappy life, if you ask me. Oh, I completed gathering all my tomes, and now I'm going to die. Okay, that is really bothering me right there. I realize it's probably a waste of my time, but I'll look for it later. I don't want to waste your guys' time either. Yeah, you get to see the stray demon boss. Alright. I don't believe I have any more. Did somebody actually get on top of the wolf? Okay, I have no blood grass or whatever. Yeah, somebody actually got on top of this wolf. Probably this way, right here. Oh, it's probably the other side then. It's probably really the only way. I mean, somebody actually took the time to walk up its tail. That looks like how you'd have to. No, that doesn't even work. There's probably a way somehow, obviously, but I mean, somebody actually took the time to do that. Alright, well, I'm going to go for a little bit further into the swamp, because I didn't really show you guys a swamp. Okay, I believe, yeah, I already explored around this part of it. Now, since this area is high in poison, I'm actually going to be putting my poison ring back on, and I'm going to put my fatty armor back on because it really protects against poison extremely good. Yeah, see that? It's really, really high in poison defense, which for here is rather important. Okay, I want that one. That's what's nice about this sword too. It's not your traditional, just regular sword, it's an Astora sword. So I'm guessing it has like a innate fire capability? And as you can see, this armor is like extremely good combined with that ring at reducing poison damage. See, there's the area I need to go to. This is like the area I missed on recording with my sorcerer. But this is the area I need to go to. I need to kill those things.
Fine, you wanna die? Here. Feel better? That's what's really nice about having a pyromancer. A lot of things are weak to fire in this game. Alright, let's just run out there. Nameless Knight. Yeah. I have purple moss clumps. Use one. Okay, how good is that Nameless Knight stuff? It's not that great. It's actually not as good even as a steel. Oh, that's right. That's what I was going for, was the exile gloves yet. So, yeah. Anyway, so that, yeah, the nameless armor is not that great, so we're not going to even worry about that. I hate it when it does that. And you see, it says my frame rate, but then in here it'll say my connection. Yeah, my connection isn't strong enough. Continue. So I don't know if it's one or the other or both. So I know my frame rate isn't exactly the greatest because I do need to upgrade my my graphics card, which I do actually want to do probably in, I want to say, are you already looking at me, buddy? You want a piece of me? That's what I thought. I have no beef with you, you have no beef with me. Ow, why did that get all glitchy? Oh, okay, now you have beef with me. Okay, is in my imagination, was that thing like incredibly weak? I remember fighting against one of those on my sorcerer, and my sorcerer couldn't do anything to me. Like, it took me a while to defeat that thing. Alright. Sunlight talisman. Okay, I'm getting tired of this. Alright, what's a sunlight talisman? That's all for that. Not that. Oh, it's probably one of these. Yep. Not sure which would be better. I do have a cleric spell I want to use eventually, but not right this minute. Ah, wolf blade grass. Okay, yeah, see there's more of this swamp area I will be exploring in time. I hate those things. They're so creepy looking. They're like dog-human creature things. They're just so nasty. They're not strong particularly, but they're fast. Kind of like the dogs. Alright. Yeah. I remember you. How comes I'm not hitting this guy? Am I not aimed high enough, or what? There we go. Yeah, it was me. You want to make some of it? Come here. Oh, you want to play with spells? We'll play with spells. Ow. I would like to point out the last one hit me the same way multiple times and did hardly, if any, damage to me. That one did it to me once and destroyed me. I actually remember him from, well, remember this setup from the last one, because if you don't kill the one, you're gonna have a little bit of an issue. Yeah, because you have to kind of kill them in order to really actually get past them. Otherwise, he'll chase you up the landmass. Which doesn't sound all too horrendous. It's just, if you're trying to flee while doing that, it's kind of a pain. Now, see, come on. Out of the swamp with you. See, why is that one so much weaker than the other one? I don't get that. Maybe it's all location. Got your attention already? Sometimes this game doesn't require a lot of skill, it just requires you to pay attention. Wow, why is my frame rate all weird today? Usually it's a little bit more, a lot more stable than that. Okay, all that's left is maybe a few little guys? I'll take that. This should be the third and final flame, and I'll get to the door and then I'll call it an episode. Because I got the two before, because for this part it's a straight line to the other flames. Da 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 da. Alright, that'll do for that one. That will open the door. Okay, I got a feeling there's something here that's going to want to fight me. Really? It's up there. I was thinking to myself, there's like no way in the world. Hello, weirdo. Yeah. he didn't fare well. Okay, those items I know I can't get very well or very easily. Ooh, this is something I wanted to show you guys too. Not this way, but the other way. There's actually items I wanted to get and show you. It's how I got the a lot of the really cool magic spells. And it's also how I found out what curse does to you. Which curse is just beyond nasty. And these little buggers are filled with it. Yeah, you don't, whoa, okay, I was standing in it. You don't want your curse meter to get up the whole way. Because curse can, like, really just, it instantly kills you. There's no way, nice, calm way of putting that, it just, you're dead. What? It's not? Okay, I really, really gotta get out of that. I'd rather take poison damage than get cursed. Oh, I see what's snarling. Big fatty over there. They're worth a lot of souls, though. But yeah, the curse meter goes down so freaking slow. But it does so unscarily amount of damage. Like, if you get cursed, you're basically screwed if it fills up the whole way. Okay, there's another one right there. I see it. It's toying with me. Moss fruit. What does moss fruit do? Temporarily boosts all resistances. Let's do that. And while I'm at it, we'll use one more of the purple. See, I'm only doing that because, well, I have enough going against me fighting these things that I don't need the extra hindrance. Yeah, see, if you do that, and if you go all the way back here, golden scroll, yeah. Now, me personally, I like to hit the treasure chest first. The antique stuff, eh, I could care less about that. That golden scroll will get you so many cool magic abilities. Just run through the swamp here. Alright, now I just gotta get back to the door, which... I don't quite remember how to do that. Whee! Okay, I'm actually at the door. I believe there's probably going to be a bonfire as soon as you go through. I mean, I would imagine. If not, I know there's one where there is one that's kind of nearby. Looks like I'm going to have to get to one that's kind of nearby. Me personally, I always like taking the high road first, because the high road, oh shit, that's not what I wanted to have happen. I thought for sure they would have turned on sight of me. But I guess not. I mean, I'm not going to complain about that concept. I like when they start transforming after they're dead, because it's just like, you got that weird, disgusting transformation sound, and they're just dying at the same time. Wow, does that sound really morbid and cruel? Here's those guys. Remember from my one episode, they walk really slow, but they're really dangerous to face head on. I know this is kind of chicken of me, but it's just like, well, why kill them when I can let them battle for me against the other guys and still collect all the souls and have to deal with less enemies? It seems kind of like a no-brainer to me. Let them do all the dirty work. And I'll just stand back and reap all the rewards from it. And just watch them have their fun. Meanwhile, they're getting beat up pretty good. Now it's 1-on-2 over there. So that'll help me out. Don't get laggy there. That is the easiest I've ever taken one of those down. I've never had that much luck before taking one of those down. Rotten pine, ember. Oh, would you stop with the glitchy laggy lags? Yeah, you guys don't scare me as much as you used to. Mostly because this account, I seem to be very powerful. Okay, we'll just clear this area out, and then I'm going to go back and I'm going to show you the other area. I know I said I was going to stop at the door. But I thought to myself, I was like, well, why not just do a little bit more than that? This way I can show you guys something that I didn't get to show you in one of my previous videos. That's actually really useful information. Hi. Hi. And that is why I like my metal shields. Hi, my friend. Way too easy. Alright, and there's the boss. I'm not going to do that for this episode because I know there's some cool stuff to be seen. And I want you guys to be able to see that. Now, this time if I see a sign on the ground, I'm not taking it until... Yeah, my computer's really laggy today. Yeah, see, I'm not seeing a sign there now. I'm not sure how that works with summoning other things to help you out. I think I might just go with the blue spirit. No, I want to go for the sunlight. I don't know why, but I like the sunlight one. Yeah, right over here's a bonfire. See, yeah, wow. Da, 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 da. Oh, does that feel good? Yeah, there's something I did want to show you. This is how you guys remember seeing the items that were on that one ledge. Well, this is how you get them. Now, see, last time I took the sorcerers over here, I was using, like, the spells and whatnot to make it easier for me not to be seen. which... Now it's not quite nearly as necessary. But there's that. And these I have a hard time fighting. Luckily this time, I'm thinking favors will be in my, it'll be in my favor, because it's close quarters. Ooh, I thought he was dead. I really did, I thought he was dead. Alright, now let's heal again. Okay, here's that corpse, great magic weapon. And I unlocked the gate. Whoa, okay, I didn't think you'd actually try to come after me, dude. Hi. Whoa. Nor did I think he would actually fit. Okay, okay. Stop. Oh no. You're not running. Think he'd actually see me. Oh yeah, that guy, I kind of tricked him the last time. But just for the sake of... Now, I'm gonna get the items.
He looks like he already went to kill me.
Yeah, I'll show you how to get the items and I'll end the episode and then I'll level up off cam just to save time. Well, save your guys' time. No, it's... Oh, that's right. It's right down here. Yeah, all you gotta do... You see, you don't even have to go all the way down there. That's if you want to get that Titanite stuff. Yeah, you'll just drop down here. You're back in Farron Keep again. Don't believe there's any secrets here. However, once I'm done... There, see, there's Atonement. And a Hollow Gem. And those annoying little frog things. I could jump down. There's more I gotta explore in here yet too, because there's a lot of items I didn't get. So there's a lot of stuff to do in there. So right, well that'll do it for this episode. Thank you guys so much for watching. Until next time, later guys.